I've been sent these samples by the guys over at Warhead Industries. They would like my feedback on what I think of these. You cunts have seen my channel. They've seen my channel. They know what I'm about. They know that I'm not going to bow down and kiss their ass because they gave me some expensive free shit. In fact, they want me to be honest. But moreover, they've set me a little task. I've got to give these fucking things a proper torture test. Now, there's a couple of rules. I can't just go and stuff one end in a vice and try and make the fucker spin. Can't do that. I've got to stress test these under normal airsoft situations. But I'm pretty sure I can add just a little bit of fucking creativity to that. So, let's do it. Let's break these fucking motors. Just because I've been tasked with stress testing these doesn't mean I've got to be mega rough with them. But I've got a few bits to do before I can start this, so... So here's what's in my fucking list for today. This one, and this one. These have come from the same person. I've got to make them good. So, I guess I'll just make them good. We'll start with the Scummy Badger. Three cell, 30C. So, hop set for point twos. Sounds like shit. Power's way low. Now, what's the first fucking thing that I'm gonna see inside here that I know is fuck? Pruin hop unit! Pile of shit. That's coming out. PTFE fucking tape. So remember this, boys and girls. Pro and hop units are amazing. Putting that tape on your hop rubber is amazing. Yet the fucking thing has a massive air leak. I fucking wonder as I stroke my fucking chin. What the fuck has he done to that barrel? It's funneled away on the inside. Of course it is. Of course it is. Now this barrel's fucked. But to prove a point, I'm still gonna use it, and I'm still gonna use that. And that. 307, 313, 312, 315, 313, 314, 314. So, even with the shit barrel, we have gained 70 FPS, 60, I've added up, by getting rid of the amazing Pro and Hop unit.
They're all shaked!
Screw missing from the gearbox already. Oh, this is gonna be a treat. Oh dear.
So here's what we fucking found. There's two magnets in his high speed gears, which are rusty. Rusty high speed gears with two magnets in it. Why you'd have two, I've got no fucking idea. There wasn't a bit of grease on any of this stuff. Not a bit of grease. It was just nasty. So that's a thing. So that'll be interesting. Now, this is completely threaded in, and this is in the wrong way. There are screw holes where this is going through here. These are all threaded out, so that's a problem. The gears were so tightly shimmed, they were just fucking compacted together, because this is a high speed motor and a high speed gear set, and Aries don't like that one little bit. So the fact it was cycling shows that it, picking up ammo means that it was so fucking tightly packed and not greased. So let's unfuck that. Okay, so let's take a little look at the bushings. This is fucked up, right? Now I've replaced the top two, and you can see that there is, although there's up and down movement, I've left that deliberately so that I can show the kind of shit we've got going on, right? So, they still spin. But you'll notice that that is sat perfect. Right in the dead center, and it's not moving up and down. Now look at these two fuckers with the original Aries bushings. He says, watch this. Ready? Look at that. That's fucked up. Let's try it out now. I've not adjusted the motor height whatsoever. I've kept it exactly how it came to me. So, safe. Semi. Yeah, that's much better. Full auto. Much better. Much better. Now, because the gears are cheap, and because the motor's cheap, it does have that sort of sound about it. If it was bad shimming, or has anything sort of really fucking weird about it, then it'd be that screeching sound. This sounds like a winding sound, and that is just down to the cheapness of the gears and the motor. They're not going to go anywhere, it's not going to break. I'm happy with that. Beautiful. Fucking beautiful. Quick test before we finally reassemble. 307, 308, 305, 306, 306, 305, 303, 307, 303. Much nicer. Right then, there we are. That's all fucking done. Turned out fine, changed out his barrel, changed out this piece of shit. Now, I'd be putting a softer hot rubber in there, personally, but that's entirely up to the customer. Semi-auto, this is fucking beautiful on 11.1, but if you're gonna use 11.1 in this, I'd honestly be saying use a 15C 850 milliamp. These guns, okay, you've got the setting for 11.1, but now it's high-speed gears and high-speed motor, you want to be using 7.4. Honestly, 7.4. I reckon 11.1 would fucking kill that on full auto. I reckon. I think it will get a bit too warm, and I think the MOSFET will fry, personally. So, that's my recommendation. What next?